And if Lana Turner doesn't set your brain awhirl, then you don't love a lovely girl.
Before I ever worked in two movies with her, I was a fan of Lana Turner from the very beginning of her career. I remember seeing Lana for the first time in They Won't Forget. It was one of the most famous debuts ever. Who could forget America's sweater girl?
What'd it be, ladies?
Dope and cherry, Fred.
How about you, half pint?
Make mine a chocolate malted and drop an egg in as fresh as you are.
She was one of the prettiest girls I'd seen on the screen. But I also thought she was a good actress. I thought this girl is going to be a big star. I sensed it, as did MGM. In 1938, the year I came to America, Lana won the part of Cynthia in Love Finds Andy Hardy. I was impressed by her performance. Lana had a magnetism so strong. She couldn't be overshadowed even by the enormously talented Mickey Rooney. When Lana was on the screen, your eyes went to her.
Oh, you can't go swimming because it'll get your hair wet, and you can't play tennis because it'll give you muscles.
Well, there's plenty of other boys who'd be glad of a chance.
Oh, don't get mad, Cynthia. But I don't see why you have to put on a bathing suit to sit around. Can't you think of something else to do?
Well, we could take a walk.
You cannot think Lana Turner without thinking MGM. They go hand in hand. She was a product of that most prestigious of movie studios. A little city in itself, where you were brought up slowly, taking acting lessons, diction lessons, fencing, horseback riding, dancing. All these skills Lana would use over the course of her spectacular career. Lana stood her ground against some of the best leading men on the screen. Stars like Spencer Tracy.
You're out!
Jimmy Stewart. Lana Turner and Clark Gable were the team that generates steam.
I want you to stay away from me, Mr. Johnson.
No, you don't. Why don't you jump in and get wet all over? You'd feel better.
You got TNT when you matched Lana Turner with Robert Taylor.
You don't want me to take you home, and you know it.
Of course I don't. Of course, I don't want you to take me home.
You know, you either got it or you don't. And Lana had it. She oozed sex appeal with an inviting combination of sweetness and sultriness. How could we escape those wonderful eyes, which on a close-up, oh well, the camera just loved Lana. Something in Lana's gaze was riveting, an undercurrent of something seething that I can best describe as inquietud, which in Spanish means someone with an internal searching, thirsting, who is never totally satisfied.
I've made a big mistake in my life, and I've got to be this way just once to fix it.
But they hang you for a thing like
that. Oh, but not if you do it right, and you're smart, Frank. You'll think of a way. Plenty of men have.
In 1953, I made my last film at MGM with Lana. I thought, here I am with two legends, Lana Turner and the director, Mervyn LeRoy, Lana's mentor from her early days. What a wonderful break to perform with this actress whom I had admired all those years from afar.
What did he say to you in Portuguese? The very last thing before he left.
He said, enjoy yourself, my son.
And you always do exactly what he says?
But I must. He's my grandfather. It's a tradition with us.
Oh, with us too. But of course he isn't my grandfather.
Working with Lana was pure pleasure. Not only was she always cheerful and thoroughly professional, Lana was honest in her acting and a wonderful listener. She had respect for her fellow actors and never tried to steal the scene.
I'm not going to see you anymore.
Don't tell me you're afraid of your husband.
I'm in love with my husband.
Are you sure? You're a real live human being.
Lana Turner exuded warmth from the very essence of her being. And with it, She stirred the passions of men and women and touched the souls of generations of movie fans. For her friendship and my experiences working with this Hollywood legend, Lana Turner will always live in my fondest memories. For Turner Classic Movies, I'm Ricardo Montalbán.